Today, I'll tell you about such a dangerous gas as chlorine. In its gaseous form, pure chlorine for the first time was obtained in the 8th century by the Swedish chemist Carl Scheele by the reaction of pyrolusite mineral or the manganese dioxide and hydrochloric acid. For my experiments, however, I choose a different approach, a more efficient method of producing chlorine. As the main reagent, I am going to use the trichloro-cyanuric acid, which is also used as a disinfectant in swimming pools. When the tablet of the substance is thrown into a swimming pool, it gradually dissolves, slowly decomposing into chlorine and cyanuric acid. To produce chlorine, I chopped the tablet of trichloro-cyanuric acid, after which I started slowly adding the hydrochloric acid to it. In an acidic environment, this acid decomposes with the release of a large amount of chlorine, which has a yellow-green color. I'm storing the released gas in a flask, as chlorine is almost 3 times heavier than air, from where it can be easily collected from the bottom of the flask. Because of this property, chlorine was used as a chemical weapon in the First World War, due to the fact that chlorine easily filled pits and trenches, especially when soldiers were there. If you accidentally inhale chlorine at high concentration, what will follow in the lungs? A mixture of acids will instantly form, which can damage the tender membrane, as well as cause a stop of breathing. Therefore, this gas shall be treated with an extreme caution. Do not repeat the experiments seen in this video. After filling all the flask with chlorine, we can now observe which properties this gas possesses. From the chemical point of view, chlorine is a powerful oxidizer, that is, it can easily take away electrons from certain substances, for example, the metallic lithium. I heated lithium with a burner so that it could melt and catch fire, after which I lowered it into the flask with the chlorine atmosphere. It is immediately evident that in the flask with chlorine, lithium burns much brighter and faster, forming smoke of lithium chloride. The same will happen with metallic sodium, which when burned in pure chlorine, will form the well-known to everybody substance, sodium chloride, or the common table salt. This, in my opinion, is the most unusual way of obtaining table salt. Remarkably, the well-known and used by many salt consists of the separately active substances chlorine and sodium, one of which explodes in water, and the other can easily cause poisoning. It just takes them to transfer one electron, and one of the most stable substances that we eat every day is formed. Let us return to the properties of chlorine. I'm pretty sure some people know that the fine iron in the form of cotton wool can burn in air. The same thing happens with iron wool when burning in an atmosphere of chlorine. In this reaction, it produces brown smoke of iron chloride, a substance used, for example, for etching in printed circuit boards. Also, copper wire can burn in the atmosphere of chlorine. Once it is only slightly heated with a lighter and lowered into the flask with chlorine, copper immediately begins to oxidize to form copper chloride, which also forms brown smoke in the flask. However, with the oxygen in the air, copper does not react this way because of the formation of an oxide film on the surface of the metal. There is another interesting reaction with chlorine. If antimony powder is added to the flask filled with chlorine, then, in such an aggressive environment, antimony spontaneously ignites, burning with the formation of antimony chlorides. Also, if you throw calcium carbide into a cylinder filled with water and then start letting chlorine into this vessel, you can observe an interesting effect, the burning of acetylene with chlorine underwater. Chlorine can react at room temperature with acetylene, forming carbon and hydrogen chloride, as well as a series of intermediate halogen derivatives of acetylene. Besides, chlorine can oxidize another halogen, iodine. This can be proven by pouring a bit of chlorine bleach into the potassium iodide solution, as the bleach contains a bit of dissolved chlorine in water. As a result of this reaction, free iodine is formed, coloring the solution into a dark color. To better see the iodine, I have added a bit of toluene into the test tube, in which iodine dissolves better and has a purple color. And the last reaction with chlorine that features red phosphorus. If you put a bit of red phosphorus into the flask with chlorine, then the reaction will begin by itself. The phosphorus will self-ignite in chlorine, burning with a dull flame, thus forming smoke from phosphorus chlorides. One of the products of the reaction is phosphorus pentachloride, which is one of the indispensable reagents in organic chemistry for the production of halogenated carboxylic acids, which is an important part of the production of certain medications. Nowadays, pure chlorine finds many uses. One of the most important ones is the production of chlorine bleaches. The bleaching properties of chlorine you can perfectly see on the example of the discoloration of a flower in a flask filled with this gas. However, it's not the chlorine itself that does the bleaching, but rather its compounds. The reaction of chlorine with water forms hypochlorous acid and atomic oxygen, which easily destroys organic dyes contained in natural sources. Chlorine reacted with the water contained in the petals of the flower and discolored them. However, pure chlorine is almost never used for bleaching because of its hazardness. For this purpose, sodium hypochlorite is produced by the electrolysis of a solution of stable salt. The chlorine formed as the anode partially dissolves in alkaline environment, forming sodium hypochlorite and sodium chloride. Also, the disinfection of the drinking water flowing from your tap doesn't go without chlorine, since all of the halogens, chlorine is the most powerful oxidizer, besides fluorine. Also, this gas is used in the production of a very common plastic, polyvinyl chloride, from which plastic windows, pipes and insulation for wires are made. At the end, we can say that the dangerous gas chlorine nonetheless has a huge importance in the manufacture of everyday household items, and also vital for our body. Now you know a little bit more about one of the other metals. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.